Since about 2016, we have been lucky enough to watch Ryan Krauser and Joe Kovac's two shot put Mavericks go at it. These two shot putters have been dominant forces with top finishes in world championships and the Olympics in recent years. Their ongoing dominance has fueled great competitions and kept the shot put event thrilling for fans. This led me to ask the question of who's better? And before anybody gives me a knee-jerk response, I wanted to take a deep dive and look at some of the physical and biological differences, awards, career stats, and statistics between the two athletes to make that determination. So let's take a look, starting with Joe Kovacs. Joe Kovacs is 34 years of age, standing at a height of 6 foot and weighing a total of 295 pounds. Kovacs, a Penn State graduate, has been one of Team USA's great stories of the past 5 years. He has taken either first or second in the last six major world events, winning world titles in 2015 and 2019, as well as adding Olympic silver medals in 2016 and 2021 to his collection. Most recently, Kovacs has also been able to bring home a bronze medal in the 2024 World Championships in Budapest, as well as bringing home the gold medal in the 2023 Prefontaine Classic, where he was victorious above Krauser. On the other hand, we have Ryan Krauser, who is 30 years of age at a height of 6'7", weighing in at 320 pounds. Krauser, who is a graduate of the University of Texas, made a big statement in the 2016 Rio Olympics, where he had a throw of 22.52 meters, which clinched the gold medal. Fast forward to Tokyo 2020, where Krauser not only defeated his title but shattered his own Olympic record, sending the shot put soaring to an astonishing 23.30 meters. Krauser's accolades also include two world championships, one Diamond League championship, and one world championship silver medal finish. Now, from a technical standpoint, these two athletes both have a very different way of starting and accelerating the shot put. Kovacs often begins his throws with a fast sweep out the back and then a fast finish, whereas Krauser is extremely methodical with his throw out the back and has a quick acceleration at the end. What Kovacs does out the back of the ring is more of a conventional way of throwing the shot put, whereas Krauser's very extremely methodical entry into the center of the ring is a very unique way of throwing that I haven't seen many shot putters perform. Personally, and from a technical standpoint, I don't believe that either way is better or worse. I simply believe that they have both found unique ways that work for them individually. I also performed an analysis of the velocity and angle of releases of these two athletes relative to their body. What's fascinating about this data is that Kovacs's angle of release relative to his body is actually higher than Krauser's release relative to his body. This is a very interesting data point considering that Krauser stands at a higher height of 6'7", whereas Kovacs is actually shorter but somehow has a higher angle of release. Even though this may be the case, Krauser's physical prowess has allowed him to get away with that lower angle of release. Now let's break down the numbers as far as distance goes. Over the past several years, both athletes have showed an unparalleled level of consistency, hurling the shot put into the elite realm of 22 meters or more with astonishing regularity. Ryan Krauser, with his explosive power, has maintained an astonishing streak of 22 meter throws, not just in championships, but across various competitions. Meanwhile, Joe Kovacs, known for his brute force and precision, mirrors this consistency. His throws consistently breach the 22-meter threshold, demonstrating a level of mastery that few athletes can claim. Now let's put their achievements into context. Compare Krauser and Kovacs to their peers on the world stage, and the disparity becomes evident. The 22-meter mark isn't just a target for them, it's a launching pad propelling them beyond the reach of their competitors. If we look at the following career trends chart, you'll notice that Kovacs was able to reach the 22-meter mark consistently around the year of 2015. It didn't take Krauser very long to catch up, where Krauser has been able to exceed the 22.5-meter mark and beyond, and actually setting a new world record of 23 37 at the U.S. Olympic Trials in Eugene in 2021. Joe Kovacs has also been able to eclipse a 23-meter mark with a throw of 23-23 in Zurich, Switzerland on September 7th, 2022. But now let's take a look at these two athletes in head-to-head competitions. Even with all that being said about their big throws, what about their average finish in competitions? Being that both athletes have competed very closely in competitions. However, the data doesn't lie on this point. Krauser has an average finish of second place, whereas Kovacs has an average finish of third place. Krauser has maintained this excellence, being that he's had first or second place finishes over almost 80% of the competitions over his career. The last data point that I chose to look at was scratches. This is something that doesn't get a lot of attention, but I found it interesting to take a look at. The question is, how accurate are these two throwers? The chart displays shows the throws at the 2019, 2022, and 2023 World Championships. What you'll discover if you look at this data closely is that Kovacs actually marked more throws. However, and this is a big however, Krauser was able to win 2 out of 3 of these competitions with a bigger throw than Kovacs. This begs the question, what do we characterize as a great thrower? Someone that's consistent? Or do we characterize greatness as the potential to take big throws at any point in time in a competition? You tell me.